Indonesia gradually reopening areas that have surpassed the 70% national vaccination target. First to reopen was Bali after it reached an 85% vaccination rate. Now, President Joko Widodo is calling on other Southeast Asian nations to start loosening travel restrictions for the vaccinated to get the wheels of the economy rolling again. He also stressed the importance for the region to be prepared for a future health crisis. Widodo's call comes ahead of a virtual summit of all ASEAN leaders on October 26 to 28. Russia reports more than 1,000 COVID-related deaths as authorities prepare to shut down workplaces in Port Moscow under lockdown. Here's the full story.
Russia's COVID-19 crisis deepened on Sunday, with the country reporting at least 1,072 deaths. 35,660 new cases were also reported, more than 5,000 of them in the capital, Moscow. President Vladimir Putin this week approved a nationwide workplace shutdown in the first week of November. Moscow will reimpose a partial lockdown from Thursday, with only essential shops, including pharmacies and supermarkets, allowed to remain open. Authorities in St. Petersburg also announced on Saturday that the city will introduce the same measures from October 30th. Despite developing its own COVID-19 vaccine early in the pandemic, Russia has vaccinated only about a third of its population, one of the lowest rates in Europe, with citizens citing distrust of the authorities and new medical products.
A health official says China's latest COVID-19 outbreak is likely to spread further. More than 100 locally transmitted cases have been confirmed over the last week across 11 provincial areas, with most linked to 13 different tour groups. The spokesperson of China's Health Commission says there is increasing risk the outbreak might spread further, helped by seasonal factors. China has largely contained the virus, but it is determined to stamp out any sporadic local outbreaks in the run-up to the 2022 Winter Olympics in February. Travel agencies are now banned from arranging cross-provincial tours that involve regions deemed of higher virus risk, while travel services linking multiple tourist attractions have been suspended. The capital, Beijing, will also impose strict travel restrictions to the city on people who have been to countries with at least one infection.